efforts to regularly participate in the daily Eucharist, come to realize, even subconsciously, that the readings for saints' days often relate to the saints' life and ministry. In fact, it's often quite obvious. For example, roots of that of the presentation of Jesus in the temple is the Gospel of Daniel's Day on February 2nd, or the feast of the care of Peter on February 22nd is the Gospel in which Jesus gives the keys of the kingdom to Peter. Or the feast of St. Mark on the 25th, Jesus sends his disciple on a mission. More contemporary, Tuesday of Jesus of Easter, we hear the Gospel about one must even come like a children. Then there's St. Norbert. I suspect that many of us in the liturgy committee, asked to pick the Gospel for Norbert's feast, would look for a Gospel in which Jesus blesses his disciples with the grace of the priest, or perhaps one in which Jesus makes big demands on his followers to be forgiven. I know that I would not have thought of this Gospel for this solemnity of our family, and I have not yet found an explanation for its selection. I can see how Norbert can be seen as a disciple who fully and responsibly, at the court of the emperor and the archbishop of Cologne, used the gift God gave him. His experience served him well as a religious leader. That is, he himself, for example, he himself, after founding the Catholic Church, quickly went on the road, and in the space of about 5 years, he had 8 new monasteries, and he had all of them chartered to him as the superior. Now, you think, I mean, that's an act of egomania, but it was done very, very wisely from what he knew about the court, that if those houses were chartered to him, then he could keep their freedom. It could not be controlled, for example, by the government or by some other outward power. So his having that leadership of those houses preserved their religious liberty for reform. What I want to suggest is perhaps a third way out approach to these readings, and that is that perhaps the Gospels use language that normally signifies just the opposite of what they're talking. In other words, what I want to suggest is that in the life of the Lord, he is making the money work for him. So he is definitely a servant who, if given 5, makes 5 more. But given his wonderful power, suppose he came forward not as a servant who multiplied talent, but as a servant who gave the multiplied talents away. As a servant who impoverished himself in order to enrich others. We see in Norbert's life and ministry a pattern of dispossession for the sake of enriching others. Suppose we think of Norbert as a disciple who became rich in enriching others. So we see that, for example, in his dancing ordination and his giving away of his G3 his very rich clothes, and comes to an ordination as a religious and poor royal daughter. Or his response to the council in Fritzlar, in which he was accused of still holding on to some of his property and money, he mistaken that it could possibly be the Archbishop, or if it was one or greater region of peace that was there for the minister. I think that we can be doubly enriched if we see in these acts not just the embodiment of Norbert's proposal, his proposal as signs of his full engagement with the Norbert movement. When we read the life, there are some phrases that appear in Norbert's life that were very much a part of the 12th century reform that began with Norbert. For example, you, Christian, you, Savior, naked to follow the naked Christ. So it is commitment to live in active poverty that Norbert is always using what the talents that are increasing in his life to enable others to establish monasteries, to enable people to follow this other phrase, solo Christian teaching, to have Christ alone as the leader. And that's where I think we see Norbert's extravagant acts of letting go, not just as part of a religious reform, but that Norbert is imitating Christ. His life is imitation of Christ. Following the naked Christ alone, Norbert took the talents given him, and in giving them away, became that good and faithful servant praised in gospel. Perhaps, Ciferni, by increasing God's bounty, by giving it away, he entered the master's house by a different way than coming to the servant.